Hey everybody, I decided I want to do a review of some of the knee pads that I've been trying out for jiu-jitsu and wrestling. So what I did is I went ahead and ordered a whole bunch of knee pads, every type that I could find, and I was going to go ahead and open them all up. And I've already tried a few of them out, so but this will be kind of like an unboxing so you can see what they come in the package and then my opinion of them. And so I'll just kind of look at each one of them here. So we got the snap-down sleeve by Axis, whatever you call it. The Brute Torque. The CK Impact knee pad. Got the Asics, that's how you say it, gel too. I knew I'd get it at some point. The McDavid, it's a knee sleeve. As you can see down there, it's got a hex protective pad. And you got the other McDavid, which is just their level one primary knee, the 410 model. And then Bauer Fiend, or whatever you say it again. It's made in Germany. It's more of a knee brace, but it has a pad in it. And it we'll go through the details on that as well. Okay, let's go ahead and start opening them up. We'll go ahead and move some of these off here to the side and open them one at a time here. Okay, the first one we're gonna go ahead and start with is the Cliff Keen Athletic CK. So that's the impact knee pad. It's almost like a volleyball knee pad, but we'll go ahead and open it up and see what we got. So as you can see here, it's pretty thick. If I lay that down flat, that's what, like, almost. No, from that angle, it makes it look like 3 inches, but if we kind of get it tilted up, it's more about 2.5 inches. But it's made of some kind of elastic fabric here. It's almost like a bluish color to it. It's a one size made in China. 29% polyester, 15 rayon, 17 stretch, 39 rubber elastic. For a pad that just strictly protects the knee, and if you're going to be doing single legs or double legs and dropping down on the knee and you're having a knee issue, I mean, this one works great. The problem I have with it, obviously, doing jiu-jitsu or anything, I mean, it just makes it somebody easy to grab their knee or get out of half guard or to progress with anything, trying to pull your knee out of anywhere. So for me, it just really won't work. It would work if I'm just having real extreme pain on it and I just need some protection for that day doing drop down. But if you're actually going to compete or actually try to, do well in class, I just don't think it's going to work too well for you. It doesn't work too well for me, but it does work really great. It's the most absorbing out of all the knee pads for actual impact. So if you're having severe pain and you're trying to stay off that knee, this would probably be the best for that, but besides that, actually trying to roll with it is fairly tough. Okay, this is the ASICS Gel 2 Sleeve Medium. I believe it was about $10 on Amazon, so it's definitely one of your cheaper knee pads. As you can see, it's pretty flat, not much to it, but it's your very basic knee pad for minimal protection that you might need. So you can kind of see the shape of the knee pad. The gel insert just kind of makes whatever shape that is. It does work for your basic protection. It's got some mesh in here for breathability. And I guess this is like a neoprene type other material around it. Fairly durable. Seems like it would last pretty well. And the gel pad isn't too massive, so I don't know if it would actually have any issues later down the road of kind of get misshapen like some of my previous knee pads. Let's see if we have any other information about it. That's pretty much it. Kinetic foam. I guess it's got that. Can absorb 90% of impact. Out of all the knee pads I tried, this one's down there towards the bottom. It's just very basic, very thin. So my injured knee really doesn't hardly do anything for it. So it's not on my recommendation list for knee injury. If you're looking for a very basic thin knee pad, just for the most minor protection, yeah, it'd work pretty well. It's really cheap. So there you go. This is the Torx by Brute. It's a wrestling knee pad. We're gonna go ahead and open it up and see what you think. It's It's got a Velcro backing here to open up the mesh bag, which I guess you could probably use for washing it. As you can see back there, it's an open mesh back. You can kind of see through that there. But it's so makes it breathable. Neoprene sleeve, compression molded protection, which is one of the things I actually don't really care for on it personally. Side stabilizers. And so let's go ahead and kind of look at it. So they're talking about these the molded pieces, which if you can kind of see there in the picture, I'm not a big fan of. It seems like it gives me some stability issues. You kind of rock off one, then it just kind of drops off, where I prefer a gel pad that's more spread out that you can just stabilize your base with. That's just my opinion on it. But it is a thick pad. I'd say that's a good half inch of padding right there compared to the other ones we've gone through, which are, you know, eighth of inch, quarter inch on some of them. But yeah, it's just stability issues for it. So I don't like it so much. Okay, this is the McDavid hex sleeve. It's protective pads, leg sleeves. One package actually comes with two. As you can see, this is medium, and it goes through dimensions on what size you need. So that's 12 to 14 inches around. We'll go ahead and open it up. So it looks like it's machine washable, includes one pair. The hex padding works not too bad. It's actually kind of one of my middle level ones that I like. So as you can see, we got two sleeves. Go ahead and look at this one right here. So McDavid, it's a real thin material, just like a sleeve should be. So I always question the durability of that. You know, if you're actually wrestling and doing jiu-jitsu with it, it seems like it might have a problem holding up. But it is fairly comfortable, breathable. This hex padding, I'd say, 3/8 inch thick. But I put it in the medium, the to buy column. Okay, this is a McDavid knee pad. It is a gel insert type pad, level one protection as they call it. This is one of the ones I did like a little bit more than the others. It's in the my top section, I would say. It's a well-built knee pad in my opinion. It's got a decent pad. I'd give it a close to a half inch. It's not the thickest pad. But it's still pretty nice. The inside is made of a neoprene type material. Seems very durable. Seems like this one would really last. I like the build quality of this. If I could combine the build quality of this and the padding that is going to be on the A6 snap down sleeve, that is would be the ultimate knee pad in my opinion. But the padding on this just isn't quite as good as the A6 snap down sleeve, so that's why the A6 snap down sleeve will be my favorite one out of these. But the build quality, this really seems like this one would last longer. But overall, really nice knee pad. It's up towards the top. If you don't need quite as much padding, I would go ahead and get this one. But if you really need that extra little bit of padding, then I would go with the A6 snap down. Okay, I'd like to start off by saying I do not know how to pronounce this name, brand, but I think it's Bauerfiend of some sort. But it's it's the most expensive knee pad I bought out of the group. I believe it goes for about $80, $90 because it's not only a pad, obviously, it's a very nice knee brace. If I was actually recovering from any type of stability knee surgery like an ACL, MCL, this would definitely be a brace slash pad that I would look at. I went ahead and gave it a shot, though, because I heard great reviews about it. I really did like it for the support of being a brace, but that's not exactly what I need right now. I needed something more of a pad for impact right on the knee where the patellar tendon attaches. So I'll go ahead and open this up, though. Show you what we got inside. So got some kind of a thick manual for this thing, so I guess it's probably got a whole bunch of different languages. But as you can see here, it's got the gel donut here, and your patella goes right inside the center of that, and it's got some little I don't know exactly what type of material, but they're support stacked almost like tendons to support your knee. It's got it on both sides. Once again, this is a very well-made knee brace pad. It's a breathable material. Let's see if what it says, if it tells me what it's made out of. It doesn't say right here, but either way, well-made, very excellent brace. If you need minimal padding for your knee, just a little bit, but you also need a decent amount of support, this knee brace is excellent. Very easy to roll with, doesn't get stuck, doesn't grab. It would be the one I would use if I didn't need more knee pads or if I didn't need more padding for my knee. But since it's not, we're gonna go ahead and review the final one that I like, which is the ASICS Snap Down, which is a whole lot cheaper. And the padding is much better for the actual knees, just the knee impact. So we're gonna go ahead and look at this one, but excellent buy if you need a knee brace slash pad. Works really well, very well made. Okay, what we got here is the ASICS Snap Down sleeve. This actually is the one that I chose that I like the best because it's got some type of anti-odor material, which most of them I'm sure have, but I had an ASICS to begin with a couple years ago, cheap one, not as nice as this. Worked pretty well for me, but then I started looking into it. I wanted to try out all the different knee pads I could and then pick one. And so this is actually the one I ended up picking. So the Snapdown is, it's very nice. I don't know if you can tell on that pad there. It's about 3/4 inch thick. It's very nice padding. After rolling with it, it felt like, you know, when I put my knee down, it was like on a pillow. It really was soft. Enjoyed it, and it doesn't stick up too much where it's not going to be a too tough of a transition when you're trying to pull your knee out from half guard or for any other position. It seems like it'll last pretty well the inside. Once again, it's made out of the typical neoprene material. It looks like made in China, like everything else, and seems like it'll last fairly well. It's better built than my last ASICS, which lasted me, I would say, I don't know how long, but at least a year. So this one should last me a lot longer, but I do like it. And let's see. And this is the one that I've chosen to continue to roll with. So my final conclusion, I'm gonna go through the order once again. It's a Snapdown. That's my number one choice. ASICS, best padding for a knee issue. If you want the best padding and some decent durability, it seems like it's gonna be the best one to go with. You have the Bauerfiend, the German-built Juggernaut. Expensive, very well padded, very good support. It's close to my second choice. I'm gonna tie this with the other McDavid, which is this one right here, for being well-built, having a good pad inside there. But if you need a brace, this one obviously wins the top of the list, but it is very expensive, 80-ish bucks, where everything else is about 20 bucks and under. So then it's going to be this one, the hex pad for the McDavid for padding also works really well. I like this one as well. That's going to be next in line. Then I would probably go with the Torque, the Brute Torque one with the padding. I just don't like the instability of those, you know. I guess they made them to look cool, but to me it just doesn't quite give me the balance and stability I would like from the other ones. But it seems like a nice, well-built one as well, under 20 bucks. Then I would go to for jiu-jitsu purposes, the ASICS once again. I guess it takes the top and the bottom. This thin pad, 9 bucks. Very cheap, very basic, will work, but it's, you know, barely there, barely doing anything. So that's the bottom choice. And then kind of a random fit in there, the CK Impact knee pad. Will do really well for a purpose of just strictly impact, but, you know, for jiu-jitsu and wrestling, it just isn't going to work for a full time. But if you have one injury that you're trying to support for a couple weeks, I think that would probably be a nice one to really take the impact, because it's more of a volleyball knee pad impact, in my opinion. It is like a pillow when you land on it, so if that's the main purpose you got, then it's in there. But for actually rolling all the time, it's just not going to work too well. Well, thanks for watching, and I hope this helps somebody figure out which knee pad would work best for them.